Hi, this is Steve with Universal Devices. I'm going to go through some quick steps showing you what you need to do to set up your Amazon Echo to your ISY. I'm going to assume that you're already familiar with logging into the ISY and going through those steps, so I'm not going to start at the beginning. The first thing is from your ISY admin console, you want to click on Help and then Purchase Modules. Now, I've already purchased quite a few modules for this ISY that I'm using, so you may not see the exact same screen as far as available modules. What you're going to look for is the one that says ISY Portal, except if you haven't purchased it, it is going to be on your right-hand side. Now, you want to make sure that you haven't purchased the MobiLink module as well. MobiLink can still work with the ISY, and if you go to our wiki under section 5, it's the last topic under section 5 that'll tell you how to use the ISY portal with MobiLink. But they both can't run on the same ISY, so if you already have the MobiLink portal installed, please send to support@universal-devices.com the UUID number of your ISY. Now, the UUID number can be found by going to Help and then About of your ISY. It's right up here. Okay, once you've purchased it, your admin console then is going to shut down. When you re-log back in, it's going to give you a message saying, hey, would you like to add the new portal? You say yes, it's going to add it. If you don't see that message, you can always force it by clicking on Help and then Manage Modules. It'll pop up and say there's a new module to add. Once that's been added, just want to point out something you're going to need to go to. It's going to be a tab here. It should say Portal Integration UDI. In yours, if you haven't set it up yet, it's going to say, do you want to accept the request from the portal? Mine have already been accepted, so I only had the option to revoke. But you'll have an option here that says, accept the request. You're also going to want to make sure your firmware is up to date, though. You can look and see what level mine is at. I'm running a beta firmware right now, but 4.5.4, I believe, is the current one. So anything over that is fine. So now that you know you have the admin console set up and ready to start the rest of the process, let's go in and you're going to want to create a portal account. So if you go to the website my.isy.io, it's going to give you an option here to create a new account. So when you do that, you're just going to fill in the information. First name, last name, email address, password, and then confirm your password. Once that's done, you're going to get an email that'll be sent to you. You need to log in with that email, and that's going to get you into the portal. Now, I have multiple ISYs that are listed here. You're only going to have one. And when you first log in, you won't see any. So what you need to do is add your ISY. So you're going to click Add ISY, and you're going to type in the UUID number that you found from your ISY. And it might look something like this. And then if you want to give it an optional nickname, you can put that here and then hit save. Now what's going to happen is it's going to pop up and it's going to have either a white dot that says it hasn't connected yet or it hasn't been connected. At this point, this is where you go back to your admin console and now you accept the request. Now your portal is connected to the ISY. Now you're going to want to go to your Amazon account and log in and make sure you've added the ISY Optimize for Smart Home V2 Smart Home skill. So if you go to alexa.amazon.com, if you don't have an Amazon account, you can set one up. They're free. And if you need to find that skill, right here where it says get more skills, and you would simply just type in ISY, hit enter, it's going to be right here, you're going to click on it, and then it's going to ask you to log in, and you're going to enable the skill. Mine says disable because it's already enabled, but you'll enable it by logging into the new account you just created on the portal. Alright, now we're going to go back here, and under profile, you want to make sure this information is all filled out. You're going to want to look at the drop down, and you're going to want to choose and make sure your ISY shows up. Also, make sure your Amazon account is linked in here. If it's not, just click where it says link Amazon account. Mine says unlinked because I've already linked it, but if you don't have it linked yet, you'll get an option that says link, and you'll want to link it. The main point is you want to see that you have information filled in on all three locations. Okay, once that's done, now you've got the ecosystem communicating. And then you simply need to go to Select Tools, go to Connectivity, Amazon Echo, and then when you first do this, you're not going to see anything listed like I have on mine. You're going to click on Devices. This will be blank. You'll go here, and you're going to look for devices then that you want to name. Now, devices that are in red I've already named. But let's say I want to name my living room lamp. I click on it, and I can just call it living room. Now, keep in mind, try to avoid using the same name over and over again. Don't say living room lamp, living room chandelier, living room sconces, because what will happen is the Echo will say, I find multiple things named living room. Which one? So try to be unique in your name descriptions. Anyhow, once you're done, you just hit save. Then you're going to want to go back, and every time you make a change, you're going to want to go back and synchronize. Now you have the option, once you've added devices, you can actually delete everything if you want and start over. But since you haven't gotten that far yet, you're going to want to go and discover devices. So you're just going to click here. It's going to go out and start synchronizing and find all the devices that are connected to your network. You can also have your Amazon Echo discover them itself by just talking to it. You can say, Alexa, please discover devices, or Alexa, discover devices. And it'll go out and start a discovery. It'll say, I found X amount of smart home devices. Keep in mind, every time you make a change, you need to go back and rediscover again.